What a war.
Max Holloway defeats Yair Rodriguez by a decision, 248-47, 149-46. It was a great victory for Max Holloway, but the chins on these two guys is so insane. I don't know how Max took all the shots he did. He took a flying knee. He was wobbled a bit by it, but that's the kind of shot that would knock out anybody. He took flush up kicks, just a plethora of different kind of big blows, and so did Yair Rodriguez. These two have definitely shown to have some of the best chins in the UFC, especially for the shots that Max Holloway took. Man, was this a competitive fight, and man, a lot of people underestimated Yair Rodriguez in this one, or they may have overestimated Max Holloway. The betting odds had Max Holloway as like a minus 650, minus 700 favorite, which was insane. I was very shocked to see that's what the betting lines were, and many did not give Yair Rodriguez any shot at winning this fight, even though Yair Rodriguez's strengths are perfect to cover Max Holloway's weaknesses. Max Holloway does not deal well with leg kicks, and you saw in this fight as well, a lot of free leg kicks given to Yair Rodriguez, who would just slam him from a distance, and Max for a while was not defending them. Max Holloway's reaction to getting kicked to the leg were two things. Number one, he would try to push Yair off balance. Taking the blow was necessary for him to get the fight to the ground, where he showed to be a little bit more dominant. And number two, he would eat the calf kick in order to land a jab or a combination afterward. Lands a jab, fakes it, and then goes to the body with a straight. This was a combination after eating calf kicks that he went to many times in the fight. And the reason why it lands is because Yair is naturally getting himself off balance when he's throwing the leg kick. The outside leg kick on the orthodox Max Holloway is naturally going to kick his leg inward, which kicks him into a stance to naturally throw out a jab. He chains up that jab for an extended combination. Max Holloway uses wrestling and uses Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu more than he's had in some of his most recent fights, and he had to do that to get away from the kicks. Well, he actually didn't need the takedown, he could have just tried to check them, but that seems to be a usual problem for Max Holloway, checking leg kicks. Instead of being defensively minded, he's more offensively minded against them, landing jabs, going for takedowns, pushing Yair, instead of actually moving away from the kicks or checking them. It kind of tells you the mindset of Holloway when it comes to these fights. He's very offensively minded. And it's not just leg kicking defense that Max Holloway has an issue with, but also, like I've mentioned, Max Holloway does not deal well when you punch with him, when you trade with him, when you get into exchanges with him. This was a blueprint from the Conor McGregor fight, when he fought Dustin Poirier the second time, when he fought Alexander Volkanovski. As you can see, one of Volkanovski's main game plans against Max Holloway in both fights was to punch with him, and he would punch hard with that big right overhand and sometimes that left hook. Yair Rodriguez took that same game plan and put power into every punch he was throwing. That's why you saw the commentators also say that Yair Rodriguez has fight-ending intentions in all of his punches. It's because he has to fight that way to trade with Max Holloway to win on the power gap. Also, with his reach advantage, he's able to dig into his punches a lot more than Max Holloway can. And that's where Max had a bit of an issue even in this fight. Even if he connected first with his punches, Yair Rodriguez is able to fire back and sometimes get the heavier blow in the exchange. Max Holloway gets exposed a bit on his defense when you trade shots with him. He doesn't really move his head as much. He takes a lot more damage in these exchanges, and most of the time against Yair, Dustin, Volkanovski, and Conor McGregor, when fighters have implemented this game plan against him, for the majority of the exchanges, he takes the harder shots. But it's when you allow him to extend combinations, to be offensive and showcase his striking skills, for example, against Kelvin Kattar, he looked like the greatest striker of all time. When you allow him to be offensive without putting any kind of resistance back at him, he will look like a world beater, and this is probably where a lot of people got misled. Max Holloway is a momentum fighter. His output is almost like a snowball effect. It starts small in the early rounds, and if his opponent is staying on the defense a little bit too long, for an example, Kelvin Kattar, not really throwing many shots back at Holloway, that snowball becomes an avalanche and it becomes way too late for you to get back into the fight. Yair Rodriguez did not let that happen from start to finish. There were a few times as Yair was tired because of throwing so much power into his shots and the fact that Holloway kept going to the body, that he would simply try to fade away from punches and just escape and create distance. And those were some of the moments where Max was having success on his output, continuously throwing out more combination. There are a few other examples of Max Holloway putting on his offense, carrying on his output and momentum against Yair Rodriguez, who started to slow down on his own attacks. For an example, here in the second round, 3 minutes and 1 second, Max Holloway is able to put on his own output after he slips on Yair's jab. Slipping on the jab gave him the green light to go into his 4-punch combination. He attacks the body with 2 hooks, both partially blocked, and then comes up to the head with a 1-2, the right hand able to get through as Yair drops his left hand. Notice how Yair did not attempt to contest Max Holloway's combination. He just allowed Holloway to stay offensive and carry on his output after his jab missed. Here's another example, second round, 2 minutes and 7 seconds. Max advances on Yair and throws in a jab as Yair is throwing a check left hook. Straight punch beats looping punch, Yair's hook misses, and Holloway extends his combination as Yair is looking to fade away from him. Straight right lands big, and then Yair is moving away. Max encloses him into the cage as that's where he wants him, and lands a right straight to the body and tries to go in for a left hook. We could look at a major example of what happened in the 5th round. The difference between how Max Holloway looks as he's moving forward compared to when the opponent is training shots with him and exchanging with him. So many times in the fight, Max was able to catch Yair as he was trying to fade away from him. He would be able to chain up his combinations and chase him down, hunt him down for the big straight. Yair is not returning with any offense, allowing Max Holloway to really showcase his attacks and his skills. But now look what happens here in the 5th round. And it's also pretty technical. So Max taps the lead hand of Yair as they're both in the orthodox stance. This gives him clearance that most likely Yair is going to counter him with the left hand. Knowing this, Max Holloway ducks under the punch and lands with the right straight to the body. He tries to follow this up with a left hook, but there's no stepping forward, ultimately causing his punch to fall short. Yair Rodriguez is trying to counter him with a right uppercut as he shifts away. They carry on, and now Yair Rodriguez is the one who attacks first, throws out a pawing right straight at Max Holloway's lead hand in order to measure distance for him to rotate his shoulders and snap right into a jab, because notice when he puts his right hand forward, he's naturally cocking back his left shoulder, putting more power into the left hand, and catches Max Holloway clean. Holloway does not move his head. He didn't show any kind of defense against this punch, even though there was a bit of a telegraph. Holloway instead reaches forward with his hand and tries to counter Yair Rodriguez with a right cross that Yair easily pulls away from. They carry on, and Yair extends with a jab in order to measure his right straight as Holloway is looking to counter him with a check left hook. Straight punch beats looping punch, and as you see it again, Holloway showed no defense. Instead, he's looking to put on his offense against Yair Rodriguez, but when they punch with each other, Yair almost always came out on top, as most fighters have against Max Holloway. Max tries to counter him with a right straight that Yair easily ducks under, and he tries to counter Holloway with a longer left hook that Max actually pulls away from. Trying to intercept Yair Rodriguez's overextension with the jab, Yair throws his own right straight in there and also slips on the inside of the jab, where they both get into a neutral position of each other and both land with a jab. They immediately continue and Yair gets his jab parried, but straight punch beats loopy punch again. Right straight lands and Holloway is again looking to get off his own attack. He throws out a right straight that Yair easily pulls away from and counters him with a big check left hook. This ultimately gets Max Holloway to move away from Yair. This is a big example of what happens when Holloway starts to exchange with opponents. And this is not the only fight, like I've said before. Dustin Poirier was victorious because he did this against Holloway. Volkanovski did with the same thing, but it was Conor McGregor who actually put out this blueprint. And not only did Yair Rodriguez copy the game plan of some of the previous opponents that had success against Holloway, he also copied some of their techniques. For an example, look at this shifting combination he throws at Holloway. In the southpaw stance, he shifts forward with a left straight to measure for a big right overhand. Who caught Holloway with this same combo? Dustin Poirier. The exact same thing. And they both worked against Holloway. And it doesn't even have to be just punching with Max Holloway. Simply just moving forward and giving some kind of threat gets Holloway a bit on edge. Holloway is still having a tough time defending the shots, showing that Holloway's offense is way better than his defense. And look, as soon as Yair starts to throw his own offense at Max, everything completely changes. As soon as he starts to be more offensive, Max respects it and has a hard time contesting it. What happens, Max lifts up his lead leg as Yair is shifting inward and throws in a left hook around the guard. Max is lifting up his lead knee, planting himself in space, either expecting a low kick or he was thinking about using his knee to shield away Yair Rodriguez, but Yair is switching stances forward and lands with a shifting left hook around the guard. As soon as that lands, Yair is able to follow this up with a big right hook. So game plan wise, according to the styles, Yair Rodriguez definitely had a style that can exploit some of the weaknesses that Max Holloway has. He's a guy that always fought this way. For an example, when he fought Korean Zombie, the whole fight was punching back with each other. And that's with one of the biggest power punchers in the featherweight division in Korean Zombie. Yair Rodriguez is going back and forth with him, exchanging shots for 5 rounds, and that definitely prepared Yair Rodriguez to go into the fight with Max Holloway to do the same sort of thing. And even though Yair has not fought in 2 years, he did not really show any ring rust. In fact, he got better in this fight. He mainly showed higher fight IQ and a much better ability to stay composed. But the difference between the Korean Zombie and Max Holloway fights were that Korean Zombie didn't go to the body as many times as Holloway did. Holloway, from like halfway into the first round, he kept attacking the body with sometimes a jab, but mostly with that right straight, digging it right into there, and you saw Yair Rodriguez slowing down in the mid rounds until the point where he was just fighting on heart. Like, he was just going after Holloway, even though he was fatigued. And that is the credit to Max Holloway's boxing skills. And here's the thing, it wasn't just the low kick that Max Holloway had an issue with against Yair Rodriguez. It was also the front kick. Many times that front kick was getting through, nakedly, no setup behind it, and Holloway wasn't really defending it that well, possibly showing a new weakness in Max Holloway's game. Not many fighters throw front kicks at Holloway. This is one of the first times a fighter has used a plethora of front kicks. This not only keeps Max away from getting on his output, using his close-range boxing skills, but even just to create damage as Holloway's trying to move away from them. But there was also a combination from Max Holloway that was consistently working for him for the majority of the fight until the late rounds, where Yair finally adjusted to it. And that was faking with the right hip or faking with the right kick in order to get Yair Rodriguez to lift up his right leg in the southpaw stance so Yair can check the kick well. After one of these reads, 18 seconds into the first round, Max Holloway was able to confirm this reaction so he can land a shifting right hook after a right kick feint to cover that necessary distance to get inside on Yair Rodriguez. When you shift forward like this, you're naturally covering a great amount of distance forward and you can get to your target a lot quicker. This is also shifting into the opposite stance. Now both fighters are going to be southpaw, giving a right hook opening for Max Holloway as Yair, lifting his lead leg up, is planting himself in space and ultimately creating an easy target for Max Holloway to land with his big right hook. And you know what's pretty funny? Yair Rodriguez actually used a similar setup against Holloway after watching what Holloway did to him. Yair Rodriguez's fight IQ is a lot higher than we thought it was. Not only did he observe Conor McGregor, Alexander Volkanovski, and Dustin Poirier's game plan, and not only did he observe and copy Dustin Poirier's shifting combination, but he also observed what Max did to him inside of the fight and then used it against Max Holloway. How many fighters are able to do that, to mimic the opponent's technique and use it against them mid-fight? But you have to also note this, why this setup is even better for Yair than it is for Holloway. For the fact that Yair already slammed a bunch of leg kicks on Holloway's orthodox stance, as Yair is also an orthodox. So there's more of a threat, there's more concern of danger for Holloway than there is for Yair Rodriguez. Max is going to respect that low kick feint more than Yair will. So look how high up Max gets up his knee in order to check the kick. This plants himself even more, but the fact that they're both in orthodox causes the angle to be a bit different for Yair to land his punches. He throws a winging right hook that nicks the back of the head of Max Holloway, but as it causes Holloway to drop his stance, Holloway falls right into a follow-up left hook, showing Yair's skills. I mean, this was some excellent stuff here. But these low feints are not just to create damage. Max Holloway intelligently used Yair's low attacks against him in order to pressure him backwards, because that's what Max generally wants in a fight. He wants you to back up to the cage more so he can enclose you and box you in for his plethora of boxing skills. So what he does is literally 8 seconds into the first round, the fight just started, and Yair threatens with a low sidekick to get Max to back away. But instead of just being concerned about the attack, he saw that Yair was not pulling the trigger. So what Max did instead was, he used this against Yair Rodriguez. He goes forward and brings his knee upward right at Yair Rodriguez, almost like a pendulum step. Now, the fact that he brought his knee upward like this, it shows Yair that lead knee, because remember, the low sidekick attacks the knee. So Max showed it to him by moving forward, and this triggers another low sidekick, just as Holloway predicted. And Holloway backsteps away from it, causing Yair to overextend with that low sidekick, and as you overextend with a low sidekick, you are simply stepping forward as you miss the target, and that's where Max Holloway is able to pressure him backwards into the cage. These two guys are showing extremely high fight IQ, and just as I say that, Holloway tried it again, like 5 seconds later, now showing his lead knee again to Yair. He wants Yair to attack it, but instead of going to the low sidekick, Yair adjusts in the fight, it lands the first round leg kick that catches Max off guard, showing Yair Rodriguez's ability to adjust. And these low attacks from Yair Rodriguez didn't just set up damage to that leg, it also allowed him to land strikes to the head. Notice how Yair is looking at Holloway, and then he looks down at Max's leg. By throwing forward a Taekwondo-style high kick, there's a weird chamber before the kick is snapped out there that it makes it look like it might go to the body. Notice this frame right here. It looks like the kick is going to go to the body, and you see Max drop his hands in order to block it. It goes right over the hand and connects on Max's chin. Even frame by frame, it is way too hard to notice that the kick is going to go to the head. If it's difficult for us to see it frame by frame, imagine how hard it was to see for Max Holloway in real time. That's the danger of a lot of Taekwondo kicks. But there's also another adjustment that Yair made against Max's right leg feint. Yair notices that this also plants Max in space. So what he simply does is he just throws a 1-2 and connects big on Max. This also happened multiple times in the fight, where Max would feint forward with the right leg, plant himself, and Yair would intercept him. And that right knee feint one time got Max taken to the ground in the third round. He went forward with it and again trying to throw a right hook, that same combination, and Yair steps forward, slips on the outside of the hook, and takes down the unbalanced Max Holloway. There was also another moment where Holloway threw a low side kick of his own and actually landed on Yair Rodriguez as Yair is trying to move away. But Yair later shows his expertise in this area. He chambers and hops forward, faking a low side kick, getting Holloway to move away from him. This fake side kick is ultimately masked as a step. He does not use it as a side kick, he uses it as a big step forward. As you remember, if you do miss a side kick, it's ultimately like a big step forward. Feinting it like this is also a similar thing, but he used this to his advantage to cover a great amount of distance forward as Holloway's moving away from him. As I said before, Holloway backs up to a lot of pressure and a lot of offense. So with this big step forward, in the opposite stance, Yair Rodriguez is able to land a big body kick on Max Holloway. But Holloway had an excellent jab in the fight. He was checking Yair Rodriguez with it, where Yair would try to make his way in. Max is able to intercept him with a jab many times, and even able to adjust where he made the miscalculation in the southpaw stance to throw a straight left, and Yair rotates his body perpendicular as he's throwing a check left hook. This gets the target off on Max Holloway's left straight and gets him caught by Yair's punch. Max Holloway adjusts, goes into the orthodox stance, and instead throws his left hand to the head, now getting Yair's attention up higher. Right now, Yair is going to go for another check left hook, but this time to the head. Holloway wanted this so he can duck under it for a right hand to the body. Excellent reading for Max Holloway. And this happened afterward as well, where Max went for a jab to the body as Yair is moving away from him, trying to carry on that momentum. But this time, instead of throwing a hook, Yair turns his body perpendicular again while he's throwing a right high kick in the southpaw stance. And it's a great view where you can see the punch slide right past Yair's body as he crushes Max Holloway's guard with the high kick. And note, Holloway's only guarding with one hand. You can see the impact of the blow, but somehow, I don't know how Max took the shot. Now, both guys had amazing jabs in the fight, both catching each other many times. Yair just simply snapping out there, Holloway getting hit by it. Again, the offense from the opponent generally tends to get to Holloway, but Max used it in order to set up things or to intercept Yair's movements. So again, in the orthodox stance, later in the fight, he goes forward and adds another wrinkle into his combination. He feints low first to drop Yair's hands so he can go up high with the left hook afterward that connects around Yair's guard as he tries to pick his hand up. And this opens up the body again. Ultimately, the goal was the same. And there's also one exchange in the fight that showed this combination continually to work. And then Yair is able to get his own shots off on Holloway to relieve himself of some of that pressure. So Max throws a jab up high, steps on the outside in order to attack the body with a right straight, and tries to follow up with a left hook that Yair effectively blocks. Backing away from the aggression, he eventually hits the cage, and this is where Holloway sees his opportunity. By landing jabs on Yair, and Yair is ducking low, almost looking like a prey in front of the predator, Holloway gets too close on top of him because of this. Yair played this smart. It was almost like he was playing possum. He made it look like he was cowering away and getting hurt by the punches. With his shoulders down, his eyes on the ground, and Max Holloway standing above him, the distance is close enough for Yair to throw up an up elbow that uppercuts Holloway's chin to the sky. After eating the blow, Holloway attempts to throw a left straight, in which Yair Rodriguez counters him with a big right uppercut, and Holloway extends with a jab as he moves away from Yair. I would never understand how Max took those two shots like that. One moment in the fight where Max showed one of the most beautiful combinations that I personally loved. Yair Rodriguez flares out his elbow and tries to snap out a jab. There's a lot of telegraph, and Holloway is able to parry it. By parrying it, he creates an entryway for him to go forward. He goes under for what it looks like a takedown, but what he actually does is he pushes Yair backwards and gets him to a parallel stance in order to defend the takedown. Holloway uses this to switch into the southpaw stance and throws in a big right hook as Yair crashes into the cage. The collision on the cage causes Yair to stay parallel and rebound off of it forward. When you hit the cage like this, you're naturally going to bounce off of it. By bouncing off of it, Yair is propelled forward into what Max Holloway throws, a flying knee. This was such an advanced combination, Max Holloway definitely showing he's one of the best fighters in the UFC. And Max did something strange on the ground when he went in for the arm triangle, so he was almost in full mount. He was in a three-quarter mount position, with the arm triangle almost completely sunk in. And for some reason, I don't know if he didn't feel confident in the grip, but it looked like it was going to be tight. He just simply lets it go. Yair did not fight out of the arm triangle. Max just kind of relieves the pressure, lets go of the grip, and that's how Yair was able to get out of the position. I'm still wondering why he did that, because he did have space to step over on his left side to get a full arm triangle in. Very strange for Max Holloway. Maybe he was more confident to land ground and pound, but ultimately, Yair was able to escape the position, showing a great amount of wrist control and taking advantage of whenever Max gave him some space. For an example right here, as Max has a headlock, he tries to readjust his position in order to put more pressure on top of Yair. But by posturing up like this, Yair fits his body underneath and takes away any kind of potential guillotine or anything like that, and also allows him to grip onto the wrist a lot easier. From there, he was able to grab one of Holloway's hands with two of his, having a lot more strength on that side, and uses that to stand up. And there was another moment for Max Holloway showcasing his skills. After slipping Yair's punch, he starts to get on the offensive and starts to avalanche Yair Rodriguez in that fifth round. So Max is watching Yair and not instantly attacking him. Yair throws out a jab, and Max is still watching him as he slips on the outside of it. He sees the left hand get cocked back, and he ducks under the punch with the overextension. This is when Max gets on the offensive and does not allow Yair to breathe. Lands a big left straight counter, and Yair attempts to roll on the punches. He slips on the outside of the jab, and Max gets on top of him, overseeing the area to see how Yair is moving instead of just getting overly aggressive. Max is able to land a knee into a right hook combination, very similar combo that he threw the whole fight, but this time actually executing the knee, actually throwing it out there. Again, no idea how Yair took those shots. And that is the end of the breakdown, man. Amazing fight by both fighters. Yair Rodriguez definitely showing how much better he has gotten, and definitely showing that he belongs with the top guys in the featherweight division. So many knocked his skills. So many people did not believe that Yair had what it takes to compete with these guys. And he put on one of the most competitive fights in Holloway's entire career. And he did it on a 2-year layoff, which is pretty crazy. The guy's only going to get better, especially as he gets more cage time. Ultimately, after this, Max Holloway deserves a title shot. As for Yair Rodriguez, I wouldn't mind a fight with Brian Ortega, given the fact that Yair most likely broke his foot and Brian Ortega is recovering from the head damage. They could do that. I would love to see a rematch of Korean Zombie one day. And there's a potential Kelvin Kattar fight. So I hope you guys enjoyed the breakdown. And if you did, make sure to give the video a thumbs up. If you enjoyed my content, make sure to subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one.